What's up, y'all? I'm back with another video up in here, man. This is KD on the Jimmy Kimmel Show. Basically, I ain't seen the video yet. You know what I'm saying? That's how this usually works, bro. I don't see the video. We watch that video together. I tell you my thoughts on the video. You listen to my thoughts on the video, and then the video ends. You know what I mean? That's how it usually goes. You know what I'm saying? You can leave comments. You know what I'm saying? Message me, whatever. You know what I'm saying? How you feel. You feel a certain way. You agree. Whatever. Don't matter. We about to see what KD got to say, man. Because he did say he was thinking about retiring in 5 years when he's 35. But then, I don't know. Let's just jump into it, man.
All right, Friday night. Look like the Cleveland Browns with a 4-game sweep to win a second straight NBA.
Damn, Jimmy, you ain't gotta do them like that, man. Made them look like the Cleveland Browns, man. They didn't win a game, so technically, yeah, I don't know.
From the world champion Golden State Warriors, please welcome their most valuable player, Kevin Durant.
I know he said back in the day he would say he would drink Scarlett Johansson's bathwater, which, nigga, that's some nasty ass shit. What you talking about, KD? Anyway, who's that on the back? It looked like some type of potential, you know what I mean? It looked like some potential.
Look at that. Thank you. Thank you so much.
It looked like they're not going to show. Hopefully Jimmy asked him about it.
Of you to bring me my own trophy too. That is actually, let me put this.
That's not your trophy, Jimmy. Damn, do you know anything about basketball, my nigga? That's the championship right there that you got your dirty hands on, and that one over there is the finals MVP, nigga. They not for you, my nigga. Damn,
or else nobody will see who's interviewing you. How you doing? Congratulations again.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
How you feeling right now?
I'm all right. My voice is a little gone. I've been screaming back to back for the last 48 hours. So.
Have you? Yeah. Did you guys have a party in Cleveland after the game?
Yeah, it's a Morton's in the hotel.
Oh,
yeah.
I see. That's the only place they'll let you go, right?
Yeah.
You got it.
No hotel. Clubs, we couldn't do that, no.
And then you flew to back to Oakland to have a party there?
I wouldn't call that. Well, yeah, we did have a party, actually, yeah, last night.
Yeah. And is it as exciting the second time in a row, or is it not as exciting? No?
It's still fun. I mean, free drinks is cool. Winning a championship, you know, you're supposed to party all summer, so you can't get tired of the first two
days.
Do you
have party plans for the whole summer? You do.
Yeah, KD, look at that smile. KD!
You should. Why not? What the heck? You worked hard all year.
Yeah, right?
I want to ask a couple of things. First of all, J.R. Smith, in that game one, where he was confused and he knew at the end. No, I'm just curious. Like, do you feel, are you guys laughing? Are you happy? Or do you feel, like, compassion for him after something like that happens?
Definitely not. I mean, I'm happy that he made that decision to do that. Especially with the game on the line, we needed that win for the sweep. But did you know
at that point, once you guys won that game, because they really had a chance to steal that game, did you know that it was over?
Yeah.
That's not the question you should have asked. You should have asked him right then and there, because he said they needed that win for the sweep. You should have asked him, going into the series, did y'all want to sweep them? Was that the plan? Was like, nigga, we about to win every single game. That was the question, Jimmy. Damn. Missed it, my nigga.
We had a good feeling. We knew we had to play well, but we knew we kind of broke them a little.
Why is he bouncing like that?
LeBron broke his own hand. So if LeBron wanted to come to the Warriors next season, would you be excited about that? Or would you feel like, all right, this is now not fair. We're the Harlem Globetrotters here.
I just don't think that'll happen, man. I don't want to go there, you know?
Yeah.
Somebody's listening is going to write something. So,
okay.
I don't know. I'll stay on my side.
You're all right. You're going to stay. You've already said that you're planning to stay.
Yeah.
It'd be hard to go anywhere else. Blunder.
I love the Bay Area.
But do you feel like you want maybe more of a challenge at some point? Because you guys are so unbelievably good.
There's a challenge every night to be that great.
I see. Challenges comes from within.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. We got enough of a challenge.
Maybe you guys should go play in the CBA and you could have even more of a challenge. You know what I'm saying?
So we're going to championship there too. I feel where you're going with that.
Yeah. Let's look at a clip here because this is the reason I asked this question. I think you scored 43 points in this game three, including that three amazing three-pointer. That really kind of sealed the deal. You don't look that happy, though. I mean,
how am I supposed to look?
I don't know. For me, I'd be like, yeah! You know, it'd be like, really? It would be ridiculous. And then I would go back to my room and I'd watch it over and over and over.
Man, Jimmy, does Jimmy watch basketball, fam? It ain't that he ain't looking happy. He mugging the crowd like, y'all niggas ain't. That's what you're looking at him like, man, y'all niggas ain't. You know what I'm saying? Like, Jimmy, man, you Hollywood, fam.
I didn't do the first part. I did watch it over and over. I guess I'm supposed to do that.
So you do go and you watch highlights of yourself when you have a good game.
Of course. You watch your show, right? You watch it back?
I never watch my show, but I would if I ever did anything athletic. In fact,
about the one-on-one game coming up. You
want to
watch that back?
The one-on-one. Do you have any advice for me in this one-on-one game with Tucker?
I don't even know what type of game you play. I don't know.
Bad. Real bad. Like a bad one. It's barely even basketball.
I'm lost.
Yeah. I'll figure it out. Don't worry. Thanks. I appreciate that. You have a parade tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
8 a.m. I got to hurry up and get back. Man.
8 a.m. Yeah, that's early for a... Why do they have to be so early?
I know, man. We're going to be out there for a couple of hours, and it's going to be hot. Last year was really hot.
And then Draymond has to get drunk at 8 a.m.?
Me too.
Yeah.
So it's like...
Who was the most valuable partier on the team this year?
Swaggy P, for sure.
Oh, it was? Really?
Yeah.
Nick, huh?
You'll be scrolling through Instagram in, like, Utah or, like, Sacramento, and it'll be a party fly with Nick Young and his shirts off on the fly.
Yeah, he had his shirt off on the plane, it seemed like.
Yeah, he's been that way since January.
Is that okay? You have other, like, stuff that you work on besides you have, like, business ventures there. What are you involved in?
A little bit of everything.
Uh-huh. And do you like doing that?
Of course, man.
You do. Is that something you look forward to focusing on full-time at some point?
At some point. I mean, I still love to play, but when I'm done, I will, you know.
You said you're going to retire when you're 35?
I would just think, you know, crazy stuff, you know, at the times of the day. I don't know why I said it at that. Maybe it was too much champagne at night. I probably should have said
that. Do you get guys texting you or calling you from other teams saying, hey, I want to be on the team. I'll take a pay cut if I have to, but I just want a winner. I just want one of these many trophies that you have.
No, not really. No.
You don't?
No, I think a lot of players might be afraid to come play for us. That backlash is a lot, you know? I don't know if guys are ready for that.
Yeah, there is some backlash, but that all seems to go away when you're carrying these over your heads, right?
Exactly. So that's my pitch to every free agent. I mean, you might get some backlash, but...
Yeah, right.
One of these
you can't put backlash on a shelf.
Exactly.
Well, congratulations. You played fantastically, and you always seem like a great guy, and I appreciate you coming down for this. Right. Have fun at the parade tomorrow. Kevin Durant, everybody. I am Jimmy Kimmel. If you want to see all our latest...
Chill out, Jimmy. I don't know. Is that how Jimmy Kimmel shows be going, bro? He didn't look like he knew anything about basketball, for real. Like worse than a Fairweather fan. Like, God bless. Hey, bro, switch it to duos. Switch it to duos. Can you hear me? Switch it from squad to duos. Yeah, bro, man. I don't know, man. Fairweather fans, man, I'm glad the championship's over so they can go away. You know what I mean? I hate, you know what I'm saying? Don't be around just because... You know what I'm saying? Don't try to bring your plate over here and get some of the food just because the food hot. When the food was cold or food was getting made, you was nowhere to be found. You know what I mean? I don't want to hear that shit, man. Go sit down, Jimmy Kimmel.